Hello, Latercon. I'm Rick Lomas, the CEO and founder of SuPy, an online digital art school where creative people learn the things they want to learn. Now, a big part of our mission at SuPy is to make the complex seem a lot easier. Today, I want to show you how to make your own Instagram and Facebook filters from scratch. Now, a lot of our students work in social media marketing, and to create these filters is something we get asked about a lot. Now, it may seem like you need a professional coder to be able to make your own filter, but you don't. It's easy to make your own from scratch with just two programs. Now, I'll be quickly showing you how to use these two programs to make a filter. Now, the first program we need is a place to make images. Now, I'll be using a program called Figma, but you can use any image editing software such as Photoshop. Now, Figma is free to use and you can get it at figma.com. Now, the second app is Spark AR, which is Facebook's tool for making filters. You can download this from sparkar.facebook.com. And if you're comfortable using basic image software, then you'll be comfortable making a filter in Spark AR. So let's go and make a filter. So the first tool we're going to talk about is Figma. Now, you can get Figma at figma.com. All you need to do is sign up, and Figma is absolutely free. I've actually already downloaded Figma, so I've got it open in my doc here. We'll talk about that in a second. The other app you need is Spark AR, which is by Facebook. So you can go to sparkar.facebook.com, click download, and obviously install it, and you'll have it in your system. So I've got mine in the sidebar like this. So the first one we're going to talk about is Figma. Now, I'm going to open up Figma, and what you'll do is when you get a brand new project is you'll have this kind of empty area. Now, in here, if you're using Figma, what you can do is draw different kind of frames. A frame is just a kind of image if you want to draw on there, and I can use this pen tool, for instance, to make a little circle like that. And obviously, this isn't what we want, but we can actually style that up by selecting that and then the sidebar, maybe changing it to red, maybe making it a little bit thicker, maybe 100. There we go, really thick. So obviously Figma is just a image editing tool or an image drawing tool. We have things like shapes in here we could use. We have text in here. We have a pen tool, all the things that we would want to use to make images. Now you can use another image editing software. You could use Photoshop, Illustrator, Sketch, any of those things will do. But we'll talk about this in a second. The other thing that we want to use is Spark AR. Now here I can make a brand new project from scratch. All I need to do is click new project. It will give me a few different options in here. Now I'm going to make one a blank project from scratch. So where do we start? Well, what we'll do when we open this is we get something that looks like this. And again, I'll just hide this for the time being and open this up. So here what we have is basically a playground to add things into an Instagram filter or a Facebook filter. Now currently there isn't anything in here. We have our guy up here in the corner. How do we see ourselves if we want to see a filter? Well, luckily there's this little camera icon up here called video. If I click here, there's a few different options. I can pick a woman like that, and I put different people in here. I can also pick myself as well. There should be your image or your video camera in here too. So there's me, and you can see me in the video. Now I'm just going to switch back for now into another person so we can just play around with someone else for the time being. There we go. Any of these will do. Now in here we can start to add different elements on top of our face. Now all I need to do is I can right click in this sidebar and click add, and then I can pick any of these items. Now what we want to do in our filter is basically track the face. So if I move my face left and right or up and down, all of our things will move in the same way. So if I click face tracker, what we'll see here is we'll get this axes start to add. You can see if I zoom in, we have these three different arrows pointing up and down. Now with this, what I can also do is right click on face tracker and add something else. Now in here, what I'm going to do is go down the list and pick face mesh. So if I click this, what we'll see over the face is basically this mesh. And as she opens her mouth and moves her head left and right and up and down, this mesh moves in time. Now, of course, we might not want to have this kind of effect, but we can just play around with it again. If I go to video, try it on different people, try it on myself. There we go. You can see my glasses and my eyes. If I open my mouth, there we go. But it moves around using my mouth and eyes, and I can squish my forehead up and down. You can see this moving in time. Again, I'm just going to pick another person for the time being. There we go. So what we want to do next is put something on top of this mesh. Now to do this, I'm going to go back to my sidebar and click Face Mesh 0. It's just the kind of automatic name that's been added. Now in here, we have things like eyes and mouth. If I unclick this, basically the eyes fill in and they cut out. And again with mouth, someone opens their mouth, we can see it in and out like that. Now the thing we want to change is not the actual movement of this mesh, but the look and feel of it. Now to do that, I'm going to go to materials and click this plus. Now what this will give us is a default material. And again, at the moment, it's just a white material that has some shadow on there. Now if I double click this material 0, this will open up the panel over here, or I can click down here in assets to actually edit the look of this. Now in this look, I have this kind of standard thing. I've got a few different things in here I can use. I can use flats, which is going to be a flat white material, no lights needed. Standard uses some automatic lighting. We have physics based, which is kind of shinier and metallic. We have face paint mode in here, which just adds it on top. We also have blended in here as well, which can do a few different things. And we also have retouching in here. So if we can actually smooth someone's skin. So this is the way that we'd actually smooth someone's skin. Again, if I just go to video and see it on myself, if I smooth myself up, you can see on my beard, particularly around here, we have this going in and out. So this is if we want to kind of make my wrinkles go away or make myself look a little bit smoother. Now what I'm going to use is actually the flat one. Or should I use face paint? Let's use flat. So we're going to use flat, which currently is just white. I can change the color of that to be whatever I want. But again, we don't want it just to be white. We actually want to have some material. Now, what do I want to put on this? Well, I can actually add my own texture. Texture is just an image, and an image is something that I can make myself. Again, I'm just going to put this back to someone else. So we can see here, just kind of white hole at the moment. So back to my Figma program. So in Figma, how do I actually draw something that goes on top of this? Well, if I just start drawing something on top of this, probably won't fit where the eyes and the mouth are. And again, I can turn my mouth and eyes on there just by selecting face mesh and material down here is how it looks. So how do I actually place things in the right place? For instance, if I want some circles around the eyes or maybe a mustache, how do I put these on here? Now, luckily, as part of Spark AR, they'll give you something that we can actually use. Again, all you need to do is go to learn, and then right at the bottom of this page at the moment is these face reference assets. You can click on here, and this gives me a few different things I can use in this folder. Now, I've already downloaded them up here, but this gives us a few things in the mesh and textures that we can use. So here I've got a feminine face, a masculine face. Again, I'll open it up. Doesn't look too, it looks a little bit scary, but here we go. We've got face mesh there and a mask on here and also some trackers if I need them. So what do we actually do with this? Well, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this middle one, face mesh, and actually open it up in Figma. So I've got my thing in here right now. I'm gonna get rid of this and I'm gonna take this face mesh and put it in here. Now currently this is a certain size and width. Now I can click on my frame that I've added here, which is using this frame tool, and I can click this shrink icon, resize to fit. And what this will do is it will fill the exact area. So what I can do now is using these kind of spatial awareness things, I can draw some circles around the eyes. I've got my nose here. I can add a mustache above the mouth and maybe something else. So I'm quickly just gonna add maybe some circles around the eyes, on both eyes, there we go. Maybe a little mustache is being drawn here, and maybe a little goatee underneath there. So I'm gonna select all of these things, I'm gonna make them red, I'm gonna thicken them up, maybe 10, there we go, maybe a little bit thicker, 15, and I can draw other things on here. Now what I want to do is have this as an image. Now what I can say on here, instead of frame one, is I can give this a name, such as sketch. Now what I can do is hide the face mesh itself by clicking this eye icon when I hover over. So I just end up with something like this. Now when I've selected this whole frame, all of these things, I can go down here and click export. So I'm gonna click plus. I'm gonna get rid of this background color. Showing exports is turned off. I'm going to export at 1x PNG, export sketch. I'm just going to put this on my desktop for now, desktop.png. Now what I can do is you can see this appear up here as an image, looks like that. All I'm going to do is add it back into my Spark AR folder. I'm going to take it and just drag it in. Now what I'll get here is a texture list on my materials underneath. So on my materials, material zero at the moment, I can actually pick a texture. What texture? I'm going to click sketch. So what we'll see instantly is this appear. We have this drawing that I've just made appear over the face. And I can change how this looks. I can change this to from flat to something like physics. You can see it's a little bit shinier on here, has some default lighting, maybe face paint on here. It feels like we can see through it a little bit more. So let's see how it looks with me. So again, cam link, there we go. Maybe it's a little bit too see-through, so maybe I'm gonna change this back to flat. So it looks like it's on top of my face. So we can see here, I've drawn this kind of cartoon look. Now, of course, what I can do is start to add more things on top of this. It doesn't have to necessarily follow my face. So with this, I'm gonna go back to Figma, and next to this, I'm gonna draw a brand new frame. So I want kind of like a circle that's gonna go around my head. I'm gonna draw a square, so something about the same size, just in the same size as what I've got in the face mesh. That's kind of hard to say. So I'm gonna draw again using my pencil tool. I'm just gonna draw some circles that go around my head. There we go, just a few in there. I'm gonna select the vector, the thing that I've just drawn. And what color should we make it? Let's make it green, there we go. And again, I'm gonna thicken it up, maybe 15, so it looks like that. Now I can draw, I can give this a name again. I'm gonna call this one loop, something that goes around my head. And again, I'm gonna export this whole thing. Click plus. Don't need this export, don't need the white background on here. And I'm gonna export it as loop. And this again is gonna go to my desktop. So loop.png should appear here. Just check it out, there we go. And again, once I've made this, I can add it to my thing. So if I want it at the moment to go around my face, I can just change this. Once I've added this into my project, there it goes. I can have the sketch, or I can actually change the material to have the different texture. So texture loop goes around my head, kind of looks a little bit strange. So again, I'm gonna go back to sketch. And instead, I want this sketch to go around my head. You can see this kind of disappears once it gets a little bit confused. So what I'm gonna do is add a new thing to my face tracker. So I'm gonna add to my face tracker a plane. Now a plane just starts by looking like that. I'm gonna make this a certain size. I'm just gonna change this to my default for now. As you can see, when she moves her head around, it moves accordingly. So in my plane, I'm just gonna make this a little bit bigger. So I'm gonna make it something like 5X. So it goes 5 times as wide, and maybe something like 7 in the Y direction. There we go, we can see this filling the entire page. And again, what I want to do is just add a quick material. I'm gonna create a new material because I don't want it to be the same as the sketch on the face. So I'm gonna create a new material. It's going grayish or white. I'm gonna double click. And here what I can do is change this texture to loop. So there, you can see it's a little bit shiny. Maybe I want to make it flat. Maybe it's a little bit too big at the moment as well. So I can change some of this stuff in plane zero. Maybe I want it to be 5 and 6. Now you can play around with this as much as you like. Again, try it out with different people. It will look different on different people, of course. And also, it'll look different on me as I turn my head. This is being tracked in 2 different ways. So again, I've got my flat loop that's going around my head, and I've got a face mesh on top of me that looks something like this. Now, obviously what we can do is we've just sketched this from scratch. We could actually work with other people on this. So I've been working with a designer called Charlotte. Charlotte Stapleton, really great designer. Everyone should go and hire her. Now what Charlotte has made is something that looks like this. You can see here, she's been using these kind of meshes to make a deer face. So deer spots and deer nose, I can turn this off and I can have this leaf ring. All I need to do is add it to my project in exactly the same way. So back in Spark AR, what I can do is add these 2 images into my textures. There we go, they're added. And then what we can do on the face mesh is gonna have a material. I'm gonna double click that and we're gonna change it to a deer face. So there we go. Maybe this is a different type. Maybe some like face paint looks pretty good. There we go. You see that going around my head. And with the ring, we want to add that in. Got a leaf ring as well. So we'll do that on the plane. I'm going to double click this and we'll change this to leaf ring. There we go. Maybe it's a little bit too big. Maybe I can shrink it down a little bit. So let's try maybe something like 3 and 5, something like that. And there we go. So we've made a really quick filter really, really quickly. We're using two different objects within Spark AR. We're using a face tracker and then two things within the face tracker, the face mesh and a plane, to make an Instagram filter really, really quickly. So you can do this yourself. It's not hard to do. Now, once you're happy with this and you think this is exactly the filter that I want to make, all you need to do is go down here. We can actually test on different devices. I can use the Spark AR player on my iOS phone or an Android to try this out. I can actually send it to Instagram in here or the Facebook camera. And once that works, I can try it out on my phone. Then all I need to do is upload and export it. I can click here and then I can pick the things I want to do. Once this has done its work, I can actually publish a brand new effect. And once this is done, I can say this is just currently working things out. And once that's ready, I could just click upload. When I click upload, it will open up in the browser and it should go straight into Facebook. So what I'll see here is this is uploaded to Facebook. And when I open the Spark AR Hub, if I'm logged into Facebook itself, what I'll see is a quick way to publish the effect. All I need to do is give it a name, pick which page I want it to do it as. Of course, it could be my personal account or it could be my company account. You can sync it up to have multiple accounts, of course. And I can add an image and basically publish it. And all I need to do is add a review video, click submit, and it takes up to 10 working days. Generally, it's pretty quick to do. Generally, I've seen filters being approved within 24 hours, but it's incredibly easy to make the effect. So making a filter is incredibly easy, and I hope this has inspired you to make your own.